It's an all-in-one experience of nudity, so you know what I'm saying.
I don't know what you're saying.
Since it's so unique of an experience, right? You're gonna you go in and you buy a ticket, like an amusement park, and mm-hmm. it'll be one cost for the entire night of whatever you eat, right? Almost like a buffet. But, you know, you're paying to be naked and eat naked and be served naked. And, you know, it's just dick, balls, and tits everywhere. Boston, you're my home. Bing, bang, boom.
Bang, bang. Welcome to the Nice Care Radio Podcast. I'm your host, Ethan Bielan, and this is Benjamin Perkins. And here we are at the Nice Care Radio
Podcast. And we got our co-host here today. It is the...
Mike.
The red-headed...
man of many talents, Derek Clay.
What's up?
We sound very thrilled to have Derek Clay on our podcast today.
We love Derek here. I don't know why you would insinuate such a thing.
I don't know. He just... The enthusiasm level. All I'm saying was abysmal.
I mean, isn't this how a lot of podcasts are? Even the successful ones?
Just abysmal?
It happened. Yeah.
We're going a different direction.
We're going depression.
Where are we going? Tell us, Mr. Derek.
Less enthusiasm,
more...
I can do that.
More just pronunciation.
More pronunciation, okay.
You like pronouncing things, Derek?
Yeah.
What's your favorite word to pronounce?
Pronoun.
You like pronouncing pronouns?
No.
He's a man of many talents.
I don't know. I'd probably say Jormungandr. Or Antetokounmpo. I like saying things that people have a hard time pronouncing.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
See, now I understand. But I also... So, okay, cool. So,
Do you know what Jormungandr is?
I don't. Enlighten me.
So, it's the Norse mythology world serpent that wraps around the world and kills Thor.
Oh.
Bet you Disney didn't tell you that shit.
I don't think it did, yeah.
Right. Yeah, the serpent did not tell me that shit.
Exactly.
What did their serpent tell you to eat the apple and die?
Something like that.
More or less, you know.
Along those lines.
Give or take, maybe a few translations, you know what I'm saying?
I mean,
yeah, we had to definitely go through the translations.
Disney just, you know, they took Norse mythology and they made it for, people with other genitalia than penises.
What?
I think the comics did that first.
Fair enough. So Stan Lee. But then Disney made it even
worse. But Stan Lee made it interesting.
I disagree. It was pretty interesting to begin with.
You a big Norse mythology guy?
I guess, you got me there. It is interesting without the comic books.
They really just made Thor a little more accepting than, I guess.
Yeah, he is not accepting.
There's nothing wrong with that, but...
He is not accepting in his original lore.
Just killing goblins over here. And...
Yeah, didn't he, like, kill Zeus?
He killed his own people, didn't he?
Yeah, he did a lot of bad things.
Wasn't Loki considered the good guy at one point?
In Norse mythology, I think he's more like worshipped because he could kill you at any moment.
Interesting. Huh. Anyways, how is your week been going, Ethan?
Been
yeah.
Pretty good.
Okay. All right. That's. And how about yours, Mr. Derek?
Pretty good.
Pretty shitty.
Do tell, pray tell.
I got COVID, but I guess it is a good time to get COVID.
Well, would you like to expand on that?
Okay, so one month later would have been ideal.
Right.
But, because hockey and football would have been on, but, you know, I was kind of like already home. I was going to watch the football games anyways on Sunday, so I just watched the football games with some sniffles.
Just write that down for the nurses.
Write that down.
Oh, I'm cleared now. I went to the gym today.
Oh, uh-huh. Okay. That's good.
So how about you, Ben? How was your weekend?
My week? My week was, my dog ate a mouse.
What's up?
You heard him.
You heard me. You heard me.
I coughed right as he said it.
I feel very, offended by this.
That's, you shouldn't be.
I shouldn't be offended.
I have the aftermath of COVID, so not my fault.
You know what? Fair enough.
Like, he just saved the world, basically.
My bad. That's my bad.
That's all over you.
I'm soaked.
So just repeat the damn thing you just said.
So.
You're what? Oh, man.
So, if I can just speak correctly. So, my dog ate a mouse.
And how did that make you feel?
Worried. Worried is the first thing that came to my mind.
Any particular reason?
Because it was dead, which means it might have died of poison. And then if your dog eats the mouse that ate the poison, your dog is poisoned because of that mouse.
You see, how when humans eat seafood and then get mercury poisoning because of the plastic that the seafood creatures eat.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Similar.
No.
Similar.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, it's up to your interpretation.
It's up to your interpretation.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Egg.
Who's
on my face?
To say.
There's egg on my face.
No one, honestly, no one can say that because I don't believe you have egg on your face right now, man. I think you're lying to me.
I think you should turn the camera on.
What kind of eggs are we talking? Like ostrich eggs, chicken eggs?
That's what I want to know.
Alligator both. Eggs?
Both.
All no three?
Way. No way, yeah. Dude. No way.
You should come over and check it out.
Maybe I will.
Maybe you should.
I'm coming over right now.
I don't see you.
This is the sound of me leaving.
That's false.
What if I wasn't lying? You'd look so silly.
I would look hilariously silly, but guess what?
And you know what else is silly?
Nothing else.
And
you know what else is silly? You know what else is fucking silly?
Oh, God.
The Packers offensive coordinator.
Wow, that really escalated quickly.
That was...
You know what else is silly? You know what else is silly? The fucking Patriots.
Okay.
Actually, they didn't look too bad for what they have. But the Packers looked ridiculous.
I mean, talk about... Oh, points in fantasy football, am I right? Whew, that's almost like our next subject. Oh, wow, what a segue. This football segment brought to you by...
Squarespace.
Feet Finders. Feet Finders, if you want to find that foot that you just fell in love with, go to www.feetfinders.com or use the Feet Finders app to find the feet that you like. Use promo code feet.
No, they do not provide with OnlyFans feet content. That is exclusive to OnlyFans, but they are working on it.
Yes, that is true. They're going to make Feet Finders Plus, 99-cent subscription per month.
That was $99.
I misread that. My bad.
So a dollar.
Yeah, there's some psychos out there.
My bad. $99. Sorry, they have to do a pretty expensive startup. It's a one-man show. That's why. It's a one-man show.
Right.
Anyways, so football.
Yeah.
Football. So,
I'm gonna play in the NFL.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go for it, man.
I mean, the more the merrier, am I right?
I think you're right. You're right about that. As of us recording, this past weekend, Thursday, Sunday, and Monday, the first NFL retired. Games went... No, he did not. Alright, sir. The first NFL games started, and we're all in fantasy football together. The Perkins Bowl Year 5. I can't believe it's already been 5 years of the Perkins Bowl, and for those who don't know what the Perkins Bowl is... It's a yearly Super Bowl party that we have fantasy football for, and we compete for a trophy. It was a money league only 1 year, and then everybody was like, I don't want to do money again. And then it was like,
dumb.
All right, let's just do a trophy then. And so now we fight for a trophy.
I say do a punishment for last place.
I do agree with that. I think we're doing a punishment for last place, other than just the dead fish trophy that we also have. If you're in last place, you're just a dead fish.
You get a trophy for it. How is that embarrassing? Unless you do something embarrassing with it.
Because your name is ingrained on that trophy forever, so that we know that you've been a loser.
How many people see the trophy versus if we post them on social media with a sign outside of Walmart saying, help, I'm homeless because I suck at fantasy football, that's a lot more embarrassing.
Yeah, but then in that scenario, people are going to start giving that person money just because people don't look at the hobo signs. They just kind of just look at the person and they're like, oh, look, a hobo holding a sign. And then they're like, here's money.
Well, we won't let them accept money. Yeah, so no. No, because you lost fantasy football. You don't deserve money.
Damn.
that's just the fact. If you're last place in fantasy football, you don't deserve money. Watch it be me this year.
You're the hobo this year.
I will gladly be a hobo if I get last place.
Anyway, how did y'all do in this first weeks of the Perkins Bowl fantasy football? How did y'all do?
Well, I gotta check because I wasn't playing Super
Bowl. Oh, that's right. You had a bye week. You've started off with a bye week because we have an uneven amount of people. How about you, Ethan?
I don't think I did too hot either. All I know is I got my blurs done off by Donovan or Landon, one of the two.
Donovan. Just name dropping.
My blower's got done off.
Hey, yo, Donovan, if you're listening to this, you have a really good team this year. My God.
There was nothing I can do on that. I mean,
wait, I had the high score this week.
Playing no one?
Yeah, that's my luck there.
Oh, no. Oh,
Hey, boy, also on hilarious. Saturday, September 24th, Twins versus A's, you can get your Twins shorts. I repeat, you can get your Twins Zubaz shorts with a special ticket package. Go to twinsbaseball.com/.
This is football, sir? This is football?
Sorry, what? That was a quick ad read for baseball. What? Sorry.
Okay. I started Rodgers, right?
Yeah, so is Matthew Stafford going to throw a receiver that isn't white?
All right.
Is that an issue for him?
Is he racist?
That's what people are saying. He could be.
Interesting. Let's just call him racist and call it a day.
Let's not do that.
I think it's safe to call him a racist. It's just really easy.
That's a slippery slope.
It's a slippery slope that I don't know if you're willing shoes for.
You're willing to go down.
Okay, maybe I'm less willing to go down now that I think about it. You know what I mean?
I just said Willie throw to a nod. I didn't say he's racist. I'm just saying that's what the mass consensus.
You know, if one person looks at it in a certain way, we all could. It's really Derek who said it.
It depends on your perception.
Exactly, and I think everyone will agree with me when I say that Derek suggested it.
I agree.
You see, we already got our first man agreeing with us.
First man to the door always gets hurt.
So I played Aaron Rodgers, and he got me. He was projected 21 points. You want to know how much he got me?
$7.
He got me three.
$3.
Three whole points.
Did you watch the game?
I did not watch his game. So I didn't even get to see the performance. I saw the highlights afterwards.
He should have had like a 74-yard touchdown. He threw an absolute dot to his receiver. No one on him. In the bread basket, and he dropped it.
Bro, come on now. Like, I know he doesn't have a lot of star wide receivers right now, but how do you drop that?
A lot. He has none.
That's the only
Sounds
reason.
Sounds like more of a him problem.
That seems like a wide receiver problem.
He just needs to be better.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is all on Rodgers, you know?
No, it is partially on its fault because he had to get the biggest contract in NFL history this year, so that allowed the Packers to have to sign a bunch of shitty receivers.
Like, I kind of am on Rodgers' side.
You're on Rodgers' side?
Yeah.
Tom Brady got Julio Jones on top of Mike Evans and Chris Godwin.
Yeah, but he doesn't always throw to Mike Evans or Julio Jones.
He's standing up for player salary. Like, if he doesn't, like, test the market and, like, push it, then all the teams are going to think, like, it's okay to pay, like, players, like, no money. It's really, if you think about it, like, if you're an employee on the smaller level, so, like, let's say, like, Walmart, like, if Aaron Rodgers is doing that at, like, a Walmart and getting, like, a Walmart salary that's higher, it's totally okay, but when he does it, it's terrible. Like, it does, that makes no sense. When he does it on, like, the NFL level.
We're talking about making $520 million versus $550 million.
That's still a lot of money. It's still pushing the market. And when you push it up even fractionally, that means, like, the guys with the lowest salaries even get it.
But then he's complaining about his receivers. But he's also complaining about his receivers, so... You wanted more money.
Well, yeah, but it's more of a fight to raise the overall cap to something that's higher, and because, like, you don't have to keep penny pinching it. It's like the NFL. It's not like Joe's poor man football team.
Well, there's a salary cap in the NFL.
You can raise it.
What is the salary cap?
And that's what he was trying to probably do. Trying to have him raise.
What is the salary cap in the NFL? Oh my god. 208.2 million.
That seems low.
I mean, for me, and my viewpoint, that seems very high. From like, my middle class...
That's yearly, though.
And the thing is, the, all
oh, that... is that yearly? That is yearly.
I think so.
You mean, like, contracts.
That salary cap is in place so that the owners make money off of their teams and keep that money. If it goes to a player, for example, it probably goes to somewhere that's not... Well, like, that money is probably on, like, more in the world than is than in an owner's bank account.
Well, you know, on the other end there, though, Derek has a point, because he Brady takes salary cuts so he can get star players, so they can afford star players.
And Aaron Rodgers is by far more talented than Tom Brady, quarterback-wise, but he has, what, 4 or 5 less Super Bowls. Or maybe even 6, maybe. I think he has 6 less Super Bowls.
I thought Rodgers has been there 6 times. Wait, 5 times. How many?
Rodgers has 1 Super Bowl.
How many Super Bowls does Brady have? No, that's not what I was looking for. I was looking for Rodgers. And was it with Green Bay?
Yeah, it was with Green Bay, I think 2011.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Who were they playing? They were playing...
Against Roethlisberger.
Oh, yeah. I was definitely rooting for him in that one. Now, I don't agree that he's better than Brady.
No, talent-wise, he can throw at better angles. He's more accurate, has a better QBR. Faster to reach 300 touchdowns.
Does he?
The stats don't lie.
Even the stats sometimes... Like, some of the stats are odd, though, because, like, for how far you throw it is included in how far the guy runs after he catches it.
Well, if you look at who threw more balls down the field or in the career when we're talking, Rodgers threw the deep ball way more.
Yeah, but he's probably allowed to do it more. Like, there's no way that Belichick lets Brady actually, like, throw far.
And that's part of what won Brady Super Bowls.
Was throwing far?
No, was not throwing far at.
Oh, yeah, the short game usually works better.
Yeah, with the Patriots, that's what...
So, I mean, maybe it's a flawed stat, because it doesn't really take into account, like, the value that, like, successful passes do in the short game, because, like...
If they did like a face off more off of a team sport game and did like Pro Bowl, like didn't they used to do quarterback for every position like challenges to see who's actually the best?
Yeah.
Didn't Aaron Rodgers and Tom Brady both stop doing those?
Well, because most of the time, they're just like, it's a waste of time for them.
Yeah, they probably don't care, really.
Yeah.
So you probably get, like, some slap-around dude
that wins it. I think Drew Brees has the record for it, I'm pretty sure.
No, I can definitely agree with putting them up in the top tier, but I don't think it's as defined as putting someone in, like, the number one spot.
Yeah,
because there's so many stats that have to do with other players as well. And, like, you know, the short game versus the long game. That whole thing
that we brought up. And using that, then a lot of Brady's success was from players running the ball after the catch.
Yeah, that's true. You could say that about Rodgers, a lot. You could say that a lot like about Rodgers. A lot of quarterbacks then as well.
That is, yeah.
I'll be back.
Oh?
Well, Rodgers, in early in his career, in his prime, threw the deep ball a lot and won. Which is harder to complete.
Did he change his play style? Like, does he do it less now?
I think it depends who he has. He does do it less. I think his arm's weaker now.
Yeah. It's not. I mean, I've seen him and Brady throw a nice deep ball still, though.
Well, yeah, they do. Brady throws a deep ball more now.
That is true. That's kind of like a switch off. It's like a switch off.
Yeah.
For them.
But yeah, so.
So.
I mean, Rodgers, when he first came out, you want to talk about Patrick Mahomes, that was Aaron Rodgers.
Right. If you were talking about, like, his rookie year was, like, incredible or something like that?
I'm talking about, well, Rodgers' early career and everything. Like, just if you watch highlights of Rodgers and highlights of Mahomes, they'll look identical.
True.
So that's why I say Aaron Rodgers is by far a more talented quarterback. Running, escaping the pressure, accuracy, stuff, but he doesn't have the Super Bowls because he doesn't have that winning mentality that Brady does taking take.
Also, he didn't have the best coach in the NFL.
Yeah, that is true. He doesn't have Mike McCarthy. He had Mike McCarthy. That's definitely an anchor on your career.
Right. Anyways, right.
And he still got bad coaching. If you watch the game, oh my god. It was terrible. Aaron Jones was running the ball like Bo Jackson, and they took him out. They gave him less carries. Why would you give a running back that's running the ball at 5+ yards per carry and just stop giving him carries the rest of the game?
Tax purposes.
Tax purposes, exactly.
Fair enough.
So, anyways.
I don't want to...
Anyways, we went off on a Rodgers Brady tangent. Ethan left halfway through, came back. I think I just like to get us back on track of fantasy football. I lost
money.
Nope. 107 was Kervik's team. I only got 70 points. All of my bench players did better than my starters. Except for, like, two. So, that was my luck this week.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
That's fantasy football
that
for you.
It really is. And I guess we'll find out in your next game, Derek, if you'll get screwed.
Imagine being a football player right now.
Oh, I got fucked in every single one of my leagues.
Same. Same.
And two of my leagues are for $100 and I think it's $30-something.
Oh, wow.
But it's week one. I'm not worried. My team's nasty, so. They'll bounce back.
I'm in a money league. We all put in 50. I think winner takes 300. And that's the best I did in the whole league, but I still, in any of my fantasy stuff, and I still lost the first game. It's not a good way to start off every single one losing.
It's week one, and the games weren't very high scoring, except for, like, the Chiefs game.
That's true. I mean, the Bucks versus, who did they play? I already forgot who they played.
They played the Cowboys.
It was just a kicking game. One touchdown scored the whole time.
Pretty much.
Even the Patriots game, whew, even though it was one-sided, it was really slow-paced.
Yeah, Brady and Dak both looked like shit. It's just Brady has Mike Evans, Godwin, and Julio Jones to throw to.
Well, he could get it down the field. They just couldn't get into the end zone. They stopped him from getting in the end zone every time, and he got sacked a few times, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, Prescott didn't look any better either. Yeah,
his number two receiver, Michael Gallup, was hurt. So... they were kind of hurting there.
What do you have to say about all of this, Ethan? I know you're such a football enthusiast.
I agree.
You watch all the games.
I mean, how can you not? I mean, it's the LFN. I mean, it's the greatest conundrum of mankind.
I'm sorry, did you say elephant?
Yeah, the NFL. Whoops, my bad.
clearly, I'm a gentleman and a scholar of football.
I mean, you're Socrates.
And you're...
Nobody.
You're a ghost. You're my conscience.
Yeah, was never here.
Let's go into our next segment. Brought to you by...
Square Man. Where you're not square. You're not a man.
I honestly thought it was Frank's Tables, but I guess we got a new sponsor.
Nope, Square Man.
Alright. Any promo code?
Use the offer code Circle7000 for
0% off. Why does this sound like a horror movie?
Because it is.
Yeah.
The Circle Man. It sounds like one of those Netflix horror movies. The Circle Man's gonna come to get you.
Big Sorks.
You don't want those angles. You want only roundness. Oh. Anyways, the name of the segment is one
is called
we keep doing.
Removed People.
What? What are you talking about?
The offer code.
Oh. I was talking about the next segment. Not the offer code. But that the offer code is important.
I do like when my players get injured right before the season and takes them out of the entire season.
That is lovely.
Yeah, it was good too. That's tough.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Shouldn't be.
Well, I am, so deal with it.
Well, you're ridiculously good looking.
I can't believe you would compliment me like that. How dare you?
How dare me?
Anyways, our next segment is called
Judgment. Brought to you by...
I'm gonna kill you if you keep interjecting.
Nope.
It's called Judgment.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Is Judgment, and we've done this a few times before, and the way it works is we will randomly select a judge, and there's a topic that we have beforehand that will be given to the two other people, and they have to come up with the best version of whatever that subject is and convince the judge that their version of whatever the subject is better than the other person's. I don't know if what I just said made any sense at all.
Made zero sense.
Cool.
You should probably repeat everything just to be safe.
So, yeah, I'm trying to think of an easier way to explain it, but there is none. So, because I don't feel like it. Suffer.
And yeah, we'll just suffer with it.
Exactly. So, the subject is
nothing,
because we're going to choose the judge.
It's funny how that works out.
Okay, so, I'm going to...
Do nothing.
Do I really hate you.
Okay, I'm done. Okay, I'm funny. Nothing though.
If nothing just happened, just like end the podcast. Nothing happens.
I'm going to do nothing.
So I have a spinner here, actually.
Spin that.
And thing. I'm gonna have us each pick, a color on the spinner, and some of the colors are bigger than the others. So, whoops-a-daisy.
Please tell us who's the judge.
I'm doing it by chance, sir.
No, just pick one.
So, Derek, what color do you want on the spinner?
I'm the judge.
What colors are there?
Red, blue, and green.
Blue.
Blue, okay. I will pick green, and Ethan will have red. Red is the biggest, so...
Spinning? I wonder who's going to be then.
It is Ethan. Ethan is the judge.
Hey, I told you this thing. You called it, and I told you.
I had to make sure. So the subject is new restaurant experiences.
New restaurant experience?
Exactly. We're going to have to create a restaurant experience for Ethan. So,
wait, new or nude?
New. I would like to preference.
Oh, new. Shit, that was my idea. A nude restaurant.
I mean, you could.
Hey, if that's your new restaurant, all right. Derek, you're on the clock. Give us your 4 minutes.
No. I'm kidding. I'm gonna think of something better.
Oh.
Something more family friendly.
Oh.
That's sad. Okay,
well.
Because I mean, there already are nude restaurants. Because some strip clubs serve food.
Well, I have a restaurant in mind.
Go for it.
I was waiting for the judge to.
All right, you have 3 minutes and 37 seconds starting now.
So get this.
Mm-hmm.
A nude restaurant.
Nope, you're disqualified.
What? You were all for it when Derek was gonna take off and run.
Okay, well, there, let's hear it. I'll hear you out then.
So.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter who's serving you. Male, female, trans, they're all naked. Right? And here's the catch.
The catch is...
You can't eat unless you're naked, too.
Uh-huh.
And you want to know what else is naked?
Tell me.
The cooks.
Oh, God.
And you can see into the kitchen. You can see them working away.
Uh-huh.
And don't worry, if you were wondering if they go behind a counter, the counters are see-through. And it's an all-in-one experience of nudity, so you know what I'm saying.
I don't know what you're saying.
Since it's so unique of an experience, right? You're gonna you go in and you buy a ticket, like an amusement park, and mm-hmm. it'll be one cost for the entire night of whatever you eat, right? Almost like a buffet. But, you know, you're paying to be naked and eat naked and be served naked. And, you know, it's just thick balls and tits everywhere.
Okay.
It'd probably be a $50 charge to get in. Of course, you get us nice family packs to get
nice
in.
Nice family packs, yeah.
Children are not allowed to be naked. That's...
Okay, well, that's probably for the better.
They can only wear bathing suits.
Good.
There's also a swimming pool area. And a fun kid play area. Because only the adults can be in the naked area. So.
Okay. What is the yearly revenue projected for this restaurant?
This restaurant... Sharks.
Sharks
being you, great white. This
I don't think
I'm asking for $2 million with a 5% share in the company. And in our first year of operation, we were planning to hit double the amount that I'm asking for.
And how much is that?
That would be $4 million if you were paying attention, sir.
Oh, I'm not paying attention. I'm kidding.
Jeez. That's right.
Oh, man.
And no tipping needed because our waiters and waitresses...
Are dead.
No. Not quite. No, not even not quite. They're far from dead. they're... Well paid over minimum wage. That's like $20 an hour.
So basically,
hour.
They're dead.
If you're getting paid $20 an hour, if that qualifies you as dead, then yes, they're basically dead.
Yeah, Yeah, that's what happens.
Were there any other questions from you, Great White Shark?
No.
Nothing?
Nope, nothing.
Nothing at all? Nothing about, like, the food that we serve?
What kind of food do you serve?
Ah, I'm glad you asked, and that I didn't prompt it to you at all. We serve all American party food.
Hold on.
Should I hold on to you, Derek? What?
I think you already are.
Oh.
And I'm scared.
Oh.
But you will be on Superman, that's for sure.
Oh, God, I forgot I told you that. Okay, well, until our judge comes back, I guess we'll split this segment into a halftime show.
Sorry about that.
Never mind, no halftime show. We're back on.
Cliffhanger, bitch.
Cliffhanger, a very big cliffhanger. Hi, how are you, Ethan?
I'm doing okay.
Well, so, we were on the food. I was going to say all hearty American, Italian, German, Mexican cuisine.
Hmm.
And that's my pitch.
No, it's not good enough.
It's not good enough. I mean, there's also like a massage room in the back for an extra $20.
For animals or like...
For the humans.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not feeling the excitement from you, from this pitch. What do I need to do? Do we need more excitement? Does there need to be more penises?
I think there needs to be less.
So, cut back the male... workers.
Yeah, cut them off.
So this is just women workers.
Like Hooters.
No.
What type of workers do you want?
I want you to fill in the blanks.
Of the cut-off dicks?
No.
fill them in!
I'm not the one pitching the restaurant.
I mean,
you
told me to cut off the dicks. So
I did not say that.
Did you not say cut them off?
You're too literal. Well,
so. Oh jeez, because I've already started.
That seems illegal.
It's not illegal if you don't get caught.
Do they consent to it though?
No, they signed a contract. I mean, that's all I got. I got no other ideas for this naked restaurant other than maybe a name. Nude food. You know, rolls off the tongue.
Nude food. No.
Damn.
Sorry.
I got nothing else in the fuel tank.
Alright, well, let's hear what Derek has to offer.
Alright. So, my restaurant will be a giant superstore like Walmart, but you sit down.
I don't think that's a restaurant. Wait,
Hold on. You sit down in little cubbies, right? Okay. You rent out a cubby. It's like a buffet, unlimited buffet with a conveyor belt that wraps around the whole building and gets food. But you can also order clothing and accessories. You want kitchen utensils, anything. Oh. So, any questions?
I defer to the judge.
I think that I'd like to know where it'd be. Did you hear me?
Apparently not.
I didn't hear you.
Where would it be?
Where would it be? Like, where in the United States? Or yeah. Where? Okay, well, right now, we're just based in Los Angeles because there is a large population there, so it's a great spot to start up. but we plan to move, I guess, just about all over the United States and maybe into Mexico, because Mexico is an easy move from LA.
Okay.
Anyone got any other questions?
If permitted, I would like to ask one, yes.
You can. No questions.
Damn it.
Derek, do you have any questions?
Yeah.
Ask them.
I would like to ask how we sanitize the conveyor belt.
I think you should ask yourself that question.
I'm going to ask myself, how do we sanitize the conveyor belt? Well, let's see. Well, we're going to solve LA's homeless problem by supplying the homeless people with jobs sanitizing the conveyor belt.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay. It sounds like you answered the question.
Or, and they can... They can have their own money, and they can go get drugs, whatever they want. I really don't care. But we're going to try to help solve the LA homeless problem, which is a big problem. There's people shitting in the streets.
I mean, yeah. All right. Just forget my idea. I would endorse this man.
You know what? I'm going to run for president while I'm at it. And we're going to just make it mandatory to have a conveyor belt in your city.
Oh my god. Ethan, if you don't choose this man.
And then I'm going to build a massive building in Utah with solar panels all over it. That you can barely see the building. It's just a big solar panel. Okay. And it's going to have a prison, a subway, a Starbucks, and a Kohl's. And then our conveyor belt. But you can only get from the stuff that I made.
Interesting. Very interesting.
And the prison is for slave labor.
So it's a slave labor camp.
I think this is our winner.
But this is like, we're talking the worst of the worst. Like, we're talking like repeat murderers and stuff like that.
This is absolutely our winner. Hands down.
Did I mention that my naked food restaurant also has insert very cool thing here? Yeah.
It's too late for that.
No. Well.
Well, I think that'll do it for me.
Well. There's, I think, one thing that... Derek, do we bring up the cliffhanger?
We can.
As one last thing, and this will be real quick. I promise you, Ethan. No less than an hour, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I told Derek... A thrill ride enthusiast that yes, I sir. Wanted to ride all 12 roller coasters at Six Flags New England, because that's the Six Flags near us.
Did we make it a challenge video?
And I told him I would do it by height, so we're going to start at the lowest height of the first drop of the smallest roller coaster and move up. Until we hit Superman. And now I regret telling him that, but I told him that I would 100% do it, and now I also regret saying that. But now I have to do it.
And then the Sky Screamer, too.
Yeah, just gotta throw that in there, because... Yeah, just gotta throw that in there.
So, I'm terrified of two rides at Six Flags. That is the Scream and the Sky Screamer. And I will vow to go on those ones.
And what about Harley Quinn? The big, rotating circle ride.
I love Harley Quinn. It's just, I almost pass out.
You almost passed out? Oh, yeah, that's right. You almost did.
Some kid wouldn't shut up next to me.
You hate to see it.
I think it's the only thing that kept me from passing. Shout out to the
kid. Shout out to the kid keeping you awake. Nice.
Knife?
Nice. Yeah, put a knife in him. You know, just get rid of that kid.
Jeez, man.
Yeah.
That's cold.
Exactly.
Jeez.
Of course.
Cheese, man.
Cheese. Cheese,
dude. Gee whiz.
Gee willikers, Batman.
Whiz, you ever had cheese whiz?
I've never had cheese whiz, no.
It's good for the first time you have it, but then you eat too much of it, and it's shit.
I believe that.
I feel like there's every single, like, bad chemical in food that the FDA allows in it.
I mean, just to make Cheese Whiz even, like, a thing, probably.
Except the fake sugars, because those are just in your, like, Coca-Cola product.
Still a chemical.
Mm.
Mm.
I'm okay with that.
Will that do it?
Yeah, that'll do it.
That will do it.
Sticks!
That's the end of this podcast, everybody.
All right, bing, bang, boom. Adios.
And remember, we're not mean. We're nice.
We are gone.
We're nice. Thank you for listening to the Nice Guys Radio Podcast. Follow us on Instagram at MoxieCrew and follow us on YouTube by the same name, MoxieCrew. If you want to send a deadfish DM, please do so, as we make up every single one when we don't have any available. And remember, we're not mean. We're nice. Stay frosty out there. She looked at me and then